seated.
Been a very special morning, hasn't it? Hearing the testimonies. I hope that God is encouraging you in your life as well. We are beginning sign-ups today, registration today for the next semester of Master Life, which will begin the week of January the 22nd. And so you can sign up. If you've completed book one, you can sign up for book two and on down the road. If you haven't taken any yet, you can start on book one beginning in January. This is going to be just a cycle that we continue the years ahead, and we hope that you'll consider being a part of that. I want us to spend today, of course, this is Thanksgiving week, and a very special time of worship already. I want us to spend some time just in guided prayer. Let's just go to the Lord in prayer together. And so I'm going to ask you to bow your head right now. We're going to spend the next few minutes, a little while, just praying, and I'll sort of guide you in that. But as we begin, you know, we're honored with the privilege. I just want you to think about what prayer is. God has blessed us with the privilege of approaching the throne of God. And Hebrews says, with confidence because of Jesus Christ. We don't cower before God's throne. We come to Him with confidence because of Christ, not because of anything that we've done. And God wants us here. God wants us to approach Him in prayer. I want you to know that He's here in this room with us now. As we begin, let me just, with your head bowed and your eyes closed, I want you to just get a vision of heaven. Just visualize. God has pulled back the curtain of heaven. And in Isaiah chapter 6, God gave Isaiah a glimpse of heaven. And He did that for us. He did that so that we might have an idea of what it is to approach God's throne. And so listen to Isaiah's words from Isaiah chapter 6. He says, in the year of King Uzziah's death, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, lofty and exalted. The train of His robe was filling the temple. Seraphim stood above Him, each having six wings. With two He covered His face, with two He covered His feet, and with two He flew. And one called out to the other, saying, holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is filled with His glory. And the foundations of the thresholds trembled at the voice of Him who cried out, while the temple was filling with smoke. And then I said, woe is me, for I'm ruined. For I'm a man of unclean lips, and I dwell among a people of unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. And then one of the seraphim flew to me with a burning coal in his hand, which he had taken from the altar with tongs. And he touched my lips with it. And he said, behold, this has touched your lips. Your iniquity is taken away, and your sin has been forgiven. And then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send, and who will go for us? And then I said, here am I. Send me. We can't come into the presence of Holy God and not be changed. And so here in these moments, would you just spend some time praying? In Master Life, we learned an acrostic just called ACTS. A-C-T-S. Adoration, confession, thanksgiving, and supplication. And so let's use that this morning as we come to the Lord in prayer. Let's just begin with adoration. That just means praising God. And so right now, just silently where you are, would you just consider just one of the attributes of God, His strength, His wisdom, His merciful nature, His faithfulness, just one of the attributes of God, and spend some time praising Him for that. We thank Him for the things He's done. We praise Him for who He is. And so just praise Him for one of those attributes now, and then just move on to another, and then another after that. Just pray and praise. Psalm 43 says, send out your light and your truth, O Lord. Let them lead me. Let them bring me to your holy hill and to your dwelling. Then I will go to the altar of God, to my God, my exceeding joy, and I will praise you with the lyre, O God, my heart and my God. Next comes confession. The Bible says if we confess our sins, God is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And so in this silent time of prayer, would you just ask that God would show you any unconfessed sin in your life, any attitudes, any actions, any things that you have neglected to do? Ask that God would reveal that to you, and then spend some time just agreeing with Him about that. That whether it's an attitude or action, something that you failed to do that He's led you to do, just agree with Him that you've offended Him in that. And that sin builds a wall between us and Him. He says if we confess our sin, if we agree with Him about our sin, that He's faithful and He's justified in forgiving us and cleansing us. Will you just right now ask Him to cleanse you and restore the joy of your salvation in these next moments? Just confess to God. Isn't it good to know that God forgives our sin, to feel the burden lifted from our hearts, knowing that whatever it is that we built between Him and us, He's taken that away. Isn't that good? And so let's thank Him. Adoration, confession, thanksgiving. We come to God. The hymn says, count your many blessings, name them one by one. And so what an appropriate week for us to come to God in gratitude. Just spend the next few minutes just reflecting on the many blessings that God has provided in your life. And if you need help, just ask Him to remind you of some, and He will. So many blessings. And now thank Him for each one. Name them one by one in these next moments. Thank God for His blessings. There's never enough time to thank God for all the blessings, but just continue in that. And we finish with supplication. After praising God, after confessing, after thanking Him for His many blessings, then we come and we intercede. We pray for those. We come to God with our requests for ourselves and for others. Philippians 4, 6 and 7 says, be anxious for nothing, but in everything, with prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. And He said, the peace that passes all understanding will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. And so let's finish by interceding. First, Let me just ask you to pray for your family, for friends. There may be some very specific prayers right now that you can lift up. So in these moments, just pray for your family and for your friends. Maybe a lost friend that you know that needs to know Christ. Carol mentioned one that we don't know necessarily much about him other than his first name. I pray there's someone in your life that you're praying for that they would come to know Christ in a personal way. Pray right now for that person. Pray that this Thanksgiving season, pray for those who may be struggling, maybe struggling in so many different ways emotionally. Maybe they've lost a loved one. Maybe they're struggling financially right now, physically, health, physically, or maybe having a shortage of food, not having enough food this time of year. Would you just lift those up? And as you do, pray for our community Thanksgiving dinner that we're going to be participating in this Wednesday up in Ferguson. And that we would meet spiritual needs, not just the physical needs, but spiritual needs as well. Pray that God would be at work in that. Now intercede for our nation, for our world leaders, for peace, for protection, for those who are in harm's way in Israel, in Gaza, in the Ukraine, other places in the world. Pray for Christians in these war-torn areas, that God's name would be glorified. We talked about that last week. Pray that God's name would be glorified in the midst of all this. And pray for our church now. Pray for South County Baptist Church, especially as we enter into this holiday season. Would you pray for Light Up the Night, for our worship services, for all the other outreach events, to just be clear that in everything we do, we would be clear in communicating that Jesus Christ really is the reason that we celebrate Christmas. And then we would do that in a way that would honor him. And would you pray, be so bold as to approach the throne of God and pray that some would come to know Christ, would be saved this Christmas season? Pray for those that we partner with in our church, for the Filipino American Christian Church and its ministry, for the Arabic Church as it serves that community. Pray for Edmund Cotta and his ministry, so many college students and their families. And pray that God would give Ed and Angie just the energy that they need. A very practical request. Pray for a car. They need a car for that ministry. And someone in our church probably has a car that they're not using. Pray that God would meet that prayer, meet that need. Now, would you pray for the Operation Christmas Child shoeboxes, which are going to be leaving our church tomorrow and heading around the world? And again, right now, would you, I led us in a prayer a little while ago, but would you just privately pray for the child? We don't know who that is or even where it is, but for the child who's going to receive that shoebox that you handled just a few moments ago. Pray for those pastors and leaders and others that are going to be following up on the ground. And just that the children would grow to be fully devoted followers of Jesus and that they would multiply themselves. They would bear much fruit to the glory of God. Now, will you pray for the new neighborhood that's opening next door to the church? Tesson Ridge has just started renting this month. We have new neighbors who are moving in right next to our church. They're going to drive past our church every day. And pray that God would open up doors for us to minister to these neighbors and that the gospel would spread there. we'd have the privilege of seeing them come to be part of a church family where they're going to hear the gospel and respond to it and hear the Bible taught clearly. Pray that we as a church would always put Jesus first. Put Jesus first in everything that we do. And that God would help us as we seek to build a culture of discipleship in our congregation. He told us to go and make disciples. That's the priority of our congregation. That's His top priority. And so our top priority is building disciples deliberately as He instructed us. Would you just right now in these moments just pray that God would help us in that, would equip us and empower us.